Oh, hey! This is a week behind the scenes of Tommirock.
Alright.
He is the man of organisation.
Told you, stop calling me Lockie.
Sorry!
Glad I got some more time than that.
Wow. Oh, I didn't even finish that. More labels.
Where is the other mic? I want to wear it like on my hat, like you are.
Yeah.
Yeah. I got to just turn it to my ear. Hey, you hear me okay? Oh, that's a bit uncomfortable.
What are you up to?
I am working on VFX stuff for Hudson Rose's music video. So at the moment, I'm just rotoscoping or masking in Fusion, so I can add all the fire. Just pop her out the front, and I've spent the last 15 years in After Effects, so I'm everything's so quick and easy for me to do in After Effects. I know Fusion can do it, and I'd love if I could just do it all in Fusion, but it's that thing where I know how to use it. It's just easier for go there. So I've been exporting, going over to After Effects for all my camera tracking, and adding the fire in the house scenes, and then bringing those plates back in and just using Fusion, because I think Fusion does a much better job of rotoscoping, like the edges and everything.
Okay.
So I do the rotoscoping of the talent in the foreground in Fusion.
So how long does that take you to do?
Took me all day yesterday, and I'm doing about 5 scenes. This is the ending scene, and I think I'll be ready for a first render to check it all out today.
So where he's doing real work, I'm labeling boxes.
It is real work, because those boxes help me do this work, because I know where everything is. I'm not spending half the day looking for something.
What are you up to?
What am I doing?
Yeah.
I'm trying to pick a cab for this tracking I did this week. This is sounding cool. I'm just trying to audition some cabs here. Thinking about trialing. This is GGD bought out, like a new one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so I mean,
contenders.
It's only $70. I might as well just try it. I wish I could I don't think you can try all this stuff. I think you gotta buy it. I thought you'd be able to try it.
Like a 7-day trial or something.
Yeah.
Message him.
Yeah.
Got anything else for us, Mitta?
Not right now.
Ah, cool.
Let's see what Josh is doing. Not interrupting you at all, are we?
No.
What's this for?
What are you doing today?
I'm mixing a client's song. Did I just press a button?
Look, that's what the cool kids do these days, right? So today, yeah, mixing a slong song by...
A slong?
A slong? A slong by...
I'm sorry.
You took me off guard. Yeah, had a client in. She came in with just a few demos of ukulele and vocals. And now it's kind of a big rock pop song now. I won't play you anything because I don't have permission to actually show it. See, I'm a massive pop fan, so
yeah,
if you write pop music, come to me.
Yeah, actually.
I want to work on so much more of this kind of stuff.
Besties in town.
Thank you.
Easy.
Easy? Easy, that's what Dan called me.
Easy. Easy. I want to talk to you about potential dates for shooting with me and Brenton. We want to do it at night.
What's the idea we're going to go with?
That space, you know. Yeah. The space. I want it to look dark, silhouette-y.
Yeah.
I'd be fine with not seeing real, like, outlines of faces and stuff like that.
Okay.
Like, if it was more...
Real it.
Yeah.
And silhouette-y.
Yeah.
We can do that. And you just want it rotating around your performance.
I think that's will be cool.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yeah, I think it will be cool. We could do it on a Steadicam.
Mm-hmm. I had this idea to kind of have the two performers, drum kit and the vocals, facing each other, and then the camera rotates around.
Yeah.
Like on a track would be ideal, but obviously that's a big ask. It might be a week or two before you
get
anyway.
Cool.
So
yeah.
Well, anyway, so what's
and the power's still on the location, right? If that's our stud,
then it should be about where we've
450. That should be a stud right there. Where there's a looks like there's a nail head there. That's a stud. Where my oily finger. Knuckle marks are.
Why are your knuckles so oily?
Because I sweat when I touch a Mitta.
It's the hot chippies, yeah.
Yeah, that's what it'd be.
So
we could put that in the center. There's a center. Well, that's interesting.
We don't have. Just hoping to get that done today.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to go buy some screws. I'll go check downstairs just in case.
Pressing red. Red sack. Poor choice of words, I think.
Shit box?
Huh?
See one of those?
Never. I'm trying to find some more screws so we can put the television on. Put the television upstairs. Was there anything with the bracket there?
No, I think I dug this out. Yeah.
Big boys? Oh, those are for your mount.
True, yep.
Yep, I'll, if we're going to do that now then.
What else do we...
Oh, you got to wait for that to export?
I do, yeah, I do. Yeah, it's still going behind you.
Yeah, cool. It's like maybe 70% of the way through.
You know what I've noticed is that Cubase performs better when you're zoomed out. Like, see how it's zoomed out like that? Cubase performs better because I think there's less...
It doesn't have to do all the visual
stuff. Yeah, all the, like, less weight on your rant, like, on your
memory. There's so much waver in your voice.
I can't think of the words. Is it? It's RAM, right?
Yeah.
No, it'd be, and because it's Apple Silicon. Well.
Say that again.
Video memory.
But isn't it and the motherboard the same thing in the M1? Yeah. So there isn't a video card.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, he's wearing one anyway.
The Apple Silicon processor has the GPUs in it. Like it's all part of the processor cores are part of the GPU.
I was just saying to the boys that I noticed Cubase runs better when I'm zoomed out.
Yeah.
Because it's less visual processing, right?
That's right. Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah. Or that especially you would notice it more when you're. Your computer would probably struggle when you've got a heap of drum tracks all quantized and cut up.
Yep. Anytime there's a lot of visual information, it doesn't seem to do so well. I'm doing my stuff right here outside your door. I'm going to set up for my session tomorrow if that's cool.
Yeah. We're going to do it out here.
All right. Yep.
Are you going to do the session in Josh's room?
He's not going to be here tomorrow, so I'll just use this.
Oh, okay.
Hey, what if we,
Sounds so nice.
One of those acoustic panels, if we put it here and cut it in the triangle to...
Joel, you know what we should do? Wrap the acoustic panel around your head. That way, wherever you go, the room's treated.
The room is treated when I arrive.
Yeah.
Joel's here, room is perfect.
Yeah. I like the idea of it, it's not going to be great because we utilize that space under there, like even not storage.
Oh, okay.
We still grab guitar amps and stuff out.
Gotcha.
I don't know why I was pointing that microphone away from myself. Is that the...
That must be for the other TV upstairs.
Is that the remote you're looking for?
No, it's the Panasonic one I'm looking for. But this would be for the other screen upstairs, I'm assuming, that we're about to put on the wall. Yeah,
I definitely, now that you've mentioned it, we do need to put something down.
Yeah.
Honestly, though, like, in this spot, a big rug would be nice over the top of carpet tiles anyway.
Unless we do, just put carpet down.
Yeah, just a bunch of these everywhere. If I wasn't so large, I'd stand up on top of this to prove my point, but I don't trust myself.
Thing is, if we were carpet down, then we've got a vacuum. This is easier to clean.
Now, you did misspeak there. You said we.
I did.
I know for a fact that is like... That is not a wee type of task.
No, it's a solo job.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we're back to editing.
Have fun.
Yeah, I'm getting so close. I want to punch out a render if I can have it render tonight.
All my plans for today are not going to plan. Better go put that TV back up.
Looks so mopey.
I just wanted to do my job.
Is everyone arriving?
Yeah.
Hello.
Hey.
How's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good.
What's happening?
Good, not much.
Yeah.
Hey. 40. Joel, you know, you
got. Oh, hey, dude.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, cool.
Yeah, just giving up a quick look, bro. Black and nice, staring to my... Yeah, dude. Hell yeah. Heaps better.
What type of arm?
It's hard to say.
What kind of backing? Like, just harmonies and stuff? Is that a hyper rare shirt?
No, it is. Get it?
Do it again.
Number one fan.
I didn't quite get it. Do it again. No, do it again.
Do what again?
Do whatever you're doing. Do it again. I didn't get it.
I'm doing it. We don't need more microphones. I'm going to shut up. I almost said it's time to buy new microphones, but it's not.
Do we need more?
No.
You about to say we don't need more microphones?
No, I almost said we need another one.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
Always. More microphones.
Maybe we need just a different flavour.
I think, like, you should just buy all the microphones that I want.
Yep.
That's a great idea.
Yep. I'll do it.
No, you won't.
Yeah, I will.
Hey,
man. Awesome.
Hello.
Okay.
Josh.
Josh does all our sound design and mixing, audio mixing for broadcasts and films and stuff like that. So Nick was just mentioning that he didn't realise we handled that sort of stuff. So I thought, well, might be a good time for you guys to meet. I'm talking about my hands.
And I was just like, you want to work with PPI? I laughed, y'all. So it's like, yeah.
That's all.
Thanks, Nick.
Keep it in-house.
Yeah, exactly.
How good.
That's good. And also, everything I do now, I just like love. Epic sound design, just like make
does,
the sound.
It does make to take it to the next level, doesn't it? Yeah. So, what are we working on today?
This is like a fashion spec for a friend's label. They're called Gin.
Yep.
And so when they during Fashion Week, she had all models out here. She's got like a new range. So I was like, oh, I'll help you out in the spec. And
is it annoying? Like, you know, obviously you're doing so many different steps and parts.
Yep.
When me or people sitting in here are like, oh, well, I like, comment as you're taking certain layers off and doing things.
Yeah. I mean, it can be, but it also gives direction.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like, I get a lot of people that sit there and they start, you know, oh, what about this? I'm like, you know, and yes, yeah, but it's like any edit. Like, if you send someone a draft edit and you're like, yeah, that's where we're going, but I've got to build this to get there. Yeah. but sometimes, you know, someone will say something, you're like, oh, okay, they're seeing something different than I thought we were on.
Yeah.
So it sort of helps shape the path, I suppose.
Yeah. We had 4 hours at this place, and I think one of those hours was spent trying to get the probe shot right, and then when I was in the edit, I was like, oh, the probe shot doesn't even suit the edit.
Oh, did you use a probe?
Yeah, just come in.
Like when we were just playing with the probe lens this morning.
They're great, aren't they?
They are, yeah.
They need a lot of light, though, don't they?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Guys, I'm back! Jacob! I'm back!